How's it going, guys? Josh here, aka Olufemi, and today we're going to talk about how to produce, shoot, and edit an event highlight video. Before though, I need to mention my channel sponsor, Envato Elements. If you can't spend a few thousand dollars on a VFX artist due to a project's budget restraint or time restraint, pay $33 a month and you get over 400,000 effects packs, transition packs, and lower thirds packs from Envato Elements. My bro, Carl McAdam.
How's it going, Josh?
It's going pretty good. I finally have you on the channel because I'm here in Sydney.
Glad to be on it.
It's been incredible seeing you over the last 4 days working on a highlights video.
Sometimes I wonder, is there more?
The watchmaker is at work to design a work of art in perfect balance within the body of his creation. In his image, there is more.
If you're still living under the condemnation of bondage of sin, look to Jesus. Look at the great.
Please tell us what this highlights video covered and how you did it.
Well, this highlights video I did last week covered Hillsong Conference Sydney. It's an annual event. We get about 30,000 people packed in the Kudos Bank Arena.
I think we've brought it down to like six main pieces of advice regarding all those people, whether you're doing a highlight video for church or just about any event. Tip number one.
Be prepared. Make sure you have a clear vision of how you want your video to look. That includes having the shot list so you know what you want to capture when you're there. Secondly, make sure you have a run sheet so you know when and where things are happening so you can get there and capture it to the best you can. And number three, make sure you have a music bed. That is a solid foundation so you can lay your clips on top. So yeah, regarding a music bed, I guess what I really like to do is I like to start off quite low, kind of like build anticipation, build some kind of like mystery behind what the event is, not giving things too much, like away too much, and gradually kind of work up the music to a point where it's going to reach a real high moment and then kind of like just kind of like take people high, like up, and just kind of like really feel the energy and like the real exciting moments of the conference or whatever the event is. And then after that, really kind of like bring people down into a real kind of like nice spot, like a real kind of like emotional spot, so you can get your points across, like show the content, the real hard content of what the conference or the event is about, and then
heart to heart stuff.
Yeah, the heart to heart stuff, like the real, especially for the conferences that we do, it's a lot of kind of like what the speakers are talking about, what the preachers are talking about, what the theme of the conference is, what the theme of the event is. It's really getting that point across. Wow. So people understand what the conference is, and it's not just full of really cool looking shots,
crazy stuff. Yeah. And it's interesting, which what I think is interesting is those highlight videos, it's all just like craziness, like just like high intensity stuff the whole way. It almost like limits the impact.
Absolutely.
Of those moments.
Yeah,
if you don't have the ebbs and flows.
Yeah,
the low moments gives emphasis to those high moments.
Oh, absolutely. It really kind of like really emphasizes the real fun parts, which are great to show, of course, because it looks really cool and that's what builds kind of like appeal and what's what people want to see. But it's also like, also you need to have those kind of moments where people can really connect and really relate. It's storytelling. You can still tell a story in a highlights video.
So I was sitting next to you for the last few days and I saw that you actually had a secondary editor.
Yep.
And what this person did was it basically kind of filtered out the clips that were coming in for, through the DPs, you know, the shooters out in the auditorium. So what the secondary editor did is they actually cut selects out of these long clips that were being shot so that you had a smaller amount of footage to deal with when you're trying to pick which footage to use in the edit. And they actually used these, they created packages of select clips for you. So they created like a Young and Free album recording session package for when, you know, the Young and Free band was doing their recording night. They did, you know, specific preacher packages when a certain person came up to preach, packages of just people jumping, high action clips. Speaking of the secondary editor, I think he just may have come through the door.
I think he did.
Hello.
Tom, the stud.
Here he is.
That is me. That's pretty gracious. Hello.
Hello,
good
Tom.
To be here, friends.
Yeah. So what Tom would do, he'd essentially just look, sift through all the footage, find the three best shots of a specific moment at conference. So it would be like the Young Free moment where they were recording their album. It would be like, it would be a contextual shot. So it would be a wide shot revealing the arena, the room, what's happening. And then we'd go into the more detailed shots. So like the close-ups of the worship leader or a crowd reaction, someone in worship, someone really enjoying themselves. And that would tell a story in itself, just through three or four shots. And we do that for each kind of like segment of the highlights video.
So what I think I remember last year was you guys just had like a ton of shooters, and I think a lot of them were kind of in training too.
Yeah.
And you just had a little bit too many cooks in the kitchen, too much footage coming through. You had such a hard deadline as far as getting all, you know, all the footage edited into a solid piece.
Yeah.
So what you did this year, I think was really smart, where you just had a couple solid shooters.
Yeah.
About half the amount of shooters I think you had last year.
Yeah.
And everything just ended up working perfectly far as you had a smaller amount of footage, but it was almost quality over quantity.
Absolutely.
So lastly, we're going to talk about who was actually part of the highlights team.
Yeah.
Go.
So it was myself, lead editor, Mr. Tom here, secondary editor, Josh here, one of our shooters, and we had three extra shooters on top of that. And Jay-Z, he was our like production manager / producer. I would liaise with him, and he would, in terms of what I needed, and he would then divide up to the shooters what I needed, like in terms of shots. So I would say to him, I need this shot, and he would then go to the shooters and say, hey, can you get this? Can you get this? And can you get this? Okay. If I didn't approach him directly.
And then we got Strand.
And we got Strand, who was my producer. It was a producer for highlights. And he basically made sure that the standard was upheld. And it was to a good standard, like the content was there. And making sure that we were telling the story of Hillsong Conference. And that it was all kind of like wrapped up in a nice, neat package.
Perfect. Thank you so much, Carl.
You're more than welcome.
And Tom as well.
Pleasure.
This has been an incredible journey that I've had this past week watching you guys work, being able to join you guys for a little bit. Thank you all you guys for watching, and as always, keep it chill.